What's up? It's Tutorial Tuesdays. What's up? What's good? It's AP. Welcome back to another episode of Tutorial Tuesdays. So I've been getting this request for the past couple of months about Instagram feed. I know I'm not that much of a really, you know, into the color, the selfie type of person, or the landscape type of person, but I'm more into what I do and what I do in shoot. But today, I'll give you guys some tips on how to curate your feeds to come up with bangers, bomb, vibe, some aesthetic. Type of pictures for your IG feed. So, before I showcase some of my personal favorites when it comes to IG feeds, some themes, some vibe, and all that, I will give you guys some tips on how to come up with some really cool feeds, okay? First and foremost, consistency. This is how often you post, how much you use a particular theme, how much you use a particular color, or how you use your feed to come up with some patterns. And if your audience knows that you come up with something like this, they will know that it's your work. They will know when you upload. They will know when you upload Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, weekly, daily, every other day, a month probably. And then they will probably get an idea of who you are. And that's branding. And under consistency, there is the color, the vibe, the edit. The color, they know when you edit something that's all blue, they will know that your feed is all blue, yellow, green, red, white, black, or whatsoever. They will know if the vibe is always moody, happy, sad, lifestyle, and travel. Next to that is composition. When it comes to composition, this is how you take your photos and how you put it on your IG feed. When it comes to taking photos, this is like how you put some big headroom. This is how you take some landscapes. There's always a sunset every other feed. There's always a building shot and all that. That is composition. Next to this is when you're using themes. Like if you use some travel photos now and later you're in the urban setting and next time you're indoors, next time it's rainy, it really depends. But if you have some consistency, like alternate or like every thread, that's a key. Mobile photography is not just mobile photography. It is photography still. It is still a style. So it's not just a phone. It's not just a phone shot. It is the phone shot. I've always been asked, what is the best camera for your IG feed, for your portfolio, or whatever? The best one is always the one that you have right near you, the one that you have right now. Eventually, you're going to be investing. So just keep on posting and keep creating, okay? And there's probably some basic tips for you on how you create your feed. So probably next time I'll come up with more, but that's probably the basic ones that I can share to you right now. Nope, we're not yet done. We're gonna showcase some of my favorites from my friends and some people that I follow on Instagram. So I hope you guys will check this out and enjoy it, okay? First feed that I'll share to you guys is RJ Wolfgang's feed. And I like his style because of how consistent it is every photo. It's different models, it's different setting, it's different layouts every time. But he has this consistent vibe of edit that, you know, it's his work. Like what I said earlier, consistency and branding. And also, when it comes to editing, he has this black and white vibe and still there are some primary colors in the mix, right? So make sure to check out his feed, okay? Follow that. So the next feed that I'll show to you guys is Ada Virtus's feed, or some of you guys may know her as Shopao02. So if you guys have been following her, you can tell that her feed is also yellow and it has this consistent vibe all over. I think it has been so many threads that it's already yellow. Even before it has always been yellow. She always has this vibe in her photos that, you know, it's her, it's yellow, and it's not too much. I still like it because even if it's outdoor and, you know, it's daylight or it's loomy, it's still yellow. So it's pretty consistent. So go for it. Make sure to check out her profile, okay? Shopao02. Next feed that I'll show to you is Roselle Basilio's feed. It has been consistent for the past couple of months. I've been noticing that and I've been telling her that I really like her photos because it has been really, really her. That neon vibe, that bluish vibe, that pink vibe, it's still there. Sometimes all over the photo, you can see all of those colors and it's really, really consistent. From portraits, landscape, product shots, she has been doing that. So mad props to her. Ang ganda ng feed niya. And I do think that you should check her out. And also check out her YouTube channel, Rosebuds. Next up is Maymay Lampa's feed. I noticed her feed for the past couple of months that it has been alternate. And then that's only in my timeline. When you go to her feed, you can tell that there's this X kind of pattern that you can check and you can always do with your feed as well. So if you've been taking a lot of photos, you have options on how to put that out. And if you want to do that, make sure it's just like a consistent person, landscape person, or a selfie person, selfie. You can see how consistent her theme is, even if it's changing all over, but you still see the pattern of person and landscape. It's consistent. And lastly, my feed, Advocate Pinoy, what's up? So what I do in my feed is that every line, there's a particular theme. I try to do that 9 blocks kind of thing, but I really can't do that because I just take some photos from my set. What I basically do when I take photos in a set or in an event or a photo shoot, there are 3 angles, 3 poses, 3 styles or anything that I can put up in just one theme in my thread. And that's pretty much my set. Here are some suggestions before I end this video. Make sure to check out VSCOcam and Lightroom Mobile and Snapseed for some editing tools that you can use on your iPhone or smartphone or whatever, Samsung or Huawei. And when I edit photos on my desktop, I use Lightroom, Photoshop, and Adobe Illustrator for some layouts and all that. So I think that's all for now. So if you want to hear more and check out more of my videos, you can just subscribe and click on my channel. I got lots of videos for you. And then if you want, and if you like this video, just hit that thumbs up, okay? And share it to your friends. Okay, that's all for now. Peace out.
It's Tutorial Tuesdays.